detained without trial, dressed in orange, ask questions they don't know the answers to. How would you like to work in home base? Words are powerful things. Sometimes a single letter H can attract helicopters. Has to be a big one. Hours I spent watching that hot tap. So here I am, Milton Jones, the world's greatest living architect, with my sister and personal assistant, Susan, and my chief engineer, Anton. So stand by for the best designed and constructed adventure ever as I give you another case of Milton Jones! I'm with Susan, flying my own personal helicopter to my latest project, a presidential palace in Bolivia.
Right, we've got a hectic schedule. We'll be in Bolivia for an hour to lay the foundation stone, then lunch in Rio and dinner in Buenos Aires. Lucky you got those helicopter lessons.
Lessons?
To fly this thing!
Yeah, a bit of a mix-up with the evening classes. But on the plus side, I've now got a Pilates license. Would you like to do some stretching?
I'd like to do some screaming! Mayday! Mayday!
Susan! Pilates is all about peace and inner strength. All that Mayday stuff just sounds like a cry for help.
Now the fuel lights come on!
Brilliant! I thought the bulb had gone.
We're losing height! Milton! I can't quite stretch far enough to reach the parachutes!
Bet you'd wish you'd come to my Pilates class now. Ah.
What?
Did you ever do that book at school about heaven and hell by the bloke with the same name as me?
Milton's Paradise Lost?
No, the other one, Milton's Parachutes Lost. Fortunately, I was able to cling on to Susan's parachute, and we began to fall to earth.
Thank goodness you two are safe.
Oh, Anton, I thought I'd never see you again.
Well, you've landed in just the right place. El Presidente will be here to inspect the foundations in 2 minutes.
Good. Are the band here? And the red carpet? Hang on! I thought I ordered for the whole site to be covered with yellow rose petals.
It was, until you arrived by helicopter.
And the 1,000 white doves released into the air?
Again, helicopter.
Right.
Welcome to Bolivia! Milton Jones, famous builder!
El Presidente, Milton is no mere builder. He is an architect.
Yeah, sorry I'm late. Just had to check on a couple of other jobs.
Humblest apologies. You are architect, not builder. If there is anything I can do...
Yeah, a cup of tea would be nice. 9 sugars, please.
I'm so sorry. Milton has a very sweet tooth.
And he has just been in a helicopter accident. That reminds me, I must get the black box out of the wreckage.
Yeah, I hadn't finished those chocolates.
I'm sorry, El Presidente. Estoy haciendo todo lo posible, pero usted tiene que entender que este señor es un genio.
Oh, Anton, how clever. Let me have a go. Buenos dias, el presidente. ¿Cómo es usted?
This is my sister, Susan.
Milton, in Spanish.
Sorry, this is my sister, Susan.
Buenos dias, Susan.
El presidente, the plans for your sensational palace will be arriving on your desk.
You mean desk?
No. The Presidente seemed confused, but presumably he was still only learning the job, hence the L in front of his name. So, how did I, Milton Jones, become the world's leading architect? Well, my dad was an architect. One day he drew up plans to extend the family. He applied to the local authority, or my mum as we called her, and I was born some 9 months later. Apparently, from an early age, everyone could tell I was going to go into the family profession. I applied to do architecture at several top universities, but ended up just doing a damp course in Aberdeen. But it was always my ambition to study in Europe, so I enrolled at the Sorbonne University in Paris, where I first met Anton. He kindly put a note under my door suggesting we meet up the next day. Got it!
Ah, there you are. You must be Milton.
Hello.
I thought we arranged to meet in the boulangerie.
Ah, not playing bull in our lingerie.
No, never mind. Let's get you in and out of the snow.
Hey. Meanwhile, back in Bolivia, we were desperate to finish the plans for the Presidente's palace, working round the clock. It was a small office, so I removed the clock, and then we all had a lot more room.
Well, how's it going?
At last, my masterpiece is finished.
Milton, it's fantastic.
It's a stunning model.
Model?
Milton, you haven't spent the entire budget on the model, have you?
Maybe.
Look, El Presidente will be here any minute. We can't tell him we've spent millions of pounds on a model.
Listen, Lego's expensive.
Oh, no, he's here.
Milton Jones! Where is my palace?
Now, El Presidente, why don't you just put that chisel down?
You have tricked me.
Just step this way, through here.
Why?
I cleverly led him into a patch of quick-drying cement. It got us out of immediate danger, but I was a little afraid I'd just set a dangerous precedent. I was always an innovator. Over lunch one day, I gave Norman Foster the idea for the London gherkin, although he ignored my plans for the Birmingham onion ring. And then there was that commission in the Far East.
Mr. Jones, this is a truly inspiring building. The imposing sheer facade, the buff light brown colour, the large triangular flap and the little portrait of the Queen in the corner. How did you come up with such a brilliant design?
Oh, I just did it on the back of an envelope.
What?
Just came to me one day, about 11 o'clock.
But I have sponsors. What am I going to tell them?
Tell them it's postmodern.
I'll be the laughing stock of the Philippines.
Good location for an envelope, though. Manila.
Listen, I want a new design for a new building as soon as possible.
It'll be with you in a jiffy. But my jiffy design turned out to be a huge success. Then my dream came true. I designed the new milk tray building. You had to get through the first level before you were allowed into the basement. And there was a floor plan on the underside of the roof. So, Anton, Susan and I flew back to London in time for the unveiling of our new headquarters, which I designed in the shape of a giant head.
Milton, are you sure this office is entirely practical?
Yes, I mean, where do we all sit?
Well, as the master creator, I should sit on the right-hand side of the brain, and Anton on the left.
What about me?
You're getting up my nose.
I don't want to sit in the nose.
Well, there's an office in each nostril, but you can only pick one.
Down in the mouth.
Because I want you to be happy.
Is this the sort of pretentious nonsense you learnt at the Sorbonne?
No, I learnt a lot of useful things on the left bank.
Name one.
Not to confuse it with the West Bank. Well, to be fair, it's a lot easier to paint someone's portrait if they're wearing a balaclava. My days at the Sorbonne were full of romance, because that is where I met Marie. Marie was everything I'd ever dreamed of. Tall, dark, a giant grain of rice, an airport made of corduroy. Okay, not everything I'd ever dreamed of. Eventually, I plucked up the courage to ask her out, and we had a wonderful day at Versailles. We ended up sitting in a park, sharing our hopes and aspirations.
Oh, Milton, you are so imaginative. Tell me more of your plans.
Well, next, I'd like to build... this. It's a giant wheel down by the Thames, dedicated to Mary Poppins.
Oh, what will you call it?
The London Umdiddle-Umdiddle-Umdiddle-I. Also designed my own mausoleum.
Oh, Milton, that's so morbid.
You're right. Perhaps I shouldn't bury myself in my work. We strolled out through the French windows, or as they call them in France, windows. I remember thinking it was as if I was walking on air. I was. We were four floors up. We were rushed to A&E, or as they say in France, A-E-E, which is also the universal noise for when you're having your stitches taken out. But back in London, for some reason, things weren't going our way.
As I say, I can only apologise. Yes, I'm so... Hello?
Good news.
No, that was the toy shop you designed. It's completely unstable.
I don't care.
They're calling it the Early Leaning Centre. And before that, I had the foreman from the Saudi project on the other line complaining that prayer times are going to be impossible.
But it's the world's first revolving mosque.
It's just not helpful, Milton.
Milton, perhaps you need to do a little more networking. Have you heard of the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.